everyone, it's your friend Think Noodles, and welcome to Ask Think, episode number 152 for Monday, May the 4th be with you guys. It's Star Wars Day, and let's get into it. Last week I asked you guys, and a lot of great different answers, which I loved, if you have a pet, what pet is it, what is its name, and why is it named that? So, we'll start with Nature Wolf, and it says, my pet's name is Logan. Logan is a German Shepherd, and what inspired my family to name him was from Wolverine. I don't know why they're so obsessed with it, but they are. Artie Tigers, I thought this one was really funny. It says, I have no pets, I'm not allowed, but I had two stick insects called Twiglet and Bubbles that died and laid hundreds of eggs. One time I was cleaning out his cage and the eggs fell onto the floor. I'm still paranoid that I will find stick insects in my wardrobe or something. And then someone at the bottom said, that's probably why you're not allowed to have pets. Although she followed up and said, no, my parents just don't want me to, or don't want the responsibility in case I don't take care of them. I just thought it was so funny. The Plush Ninja says, I used to have a pet budgie, which I think is also known as a parakeet, named Kiwi Jr. Jr. because Kiwi the original died. He was green and he looked like a kiwi, thus the name Kiwi Jr. and looked exactly like Kiwi. Hunter Hayes said, my dog's a Weimaraner named Wrigley. We didn't name her, but she's named after a baseball field called Wrigley Field. It's the field the Chicago Cubs play on. I love her because I play baseball and love baseball. Adventure Universe says, Nacho the Chihuahua. I don't know how to spell Chihuahua, but Nacho because I wanted a nacho. And her ears look like nacho chips. Christian Mangoy says, if I had a pet, it would be a dog. And I would name that dog Ohana, because Ohana means family. And family means nobody gets left behind or forgotten. You forgot the last part, come on! Wolf Girl says, I have a dog. His name is Nike. We called him that because it's the name of a shoe brand like my mom's old dog Adidas, which is really cool. Neth110 says, I have a cat and a kitten. My cat's name is Marshmallow, and I named her that when we got her in 2009 or 2010 because she was white, and it worked out later because she developed brown too, so it looked like she was toasting. I don't think you roast marshmallows. Well, I guess toast marshmallows. I don't know. Either way, cooking your kitty cat. My kitten is named Noodles, and I suggested it as a joke because my dad had said we had to name her what fit her personality and how she looked, not named after other pets or other people. My brother and dad actually like that because she is noodle-colored, and Noodles, for some reason, really describes her silly personality. So you inspired the joke, which made us eventually choose to name her that. Rip Your Shirt Off says, I named my cat Spike because when he was young, he had spiky ears. Headline Gamer said, if I could have a pet, it would be a turtle because they are calm and I like turtle. And I would name it Jeff because of the vine. Love your videos. Creative Creamer says, I have a Japanese tortoise and properly named it Tank because I really like, I guess, My Little Pony Turtle? MLP? I don't know. Called Tank, and it looks just like a tank. He's cute though. And I think tortoises will actually probably outlive you. They live for like over 100 years. I actually met a turtle, or I don't know, I didn't not shake hands with them or anything, but I did see a tortoise that was in like a sanctuary. And I think they were saying he was 120 years old, and it was huge. You could ride him. He was massive. Letitia Ann says, my Shih Tzu's name is Rocky. I give him that name because his attitude matches one of a rock. He's lazy, although rocks are physically incapable of moving, unlike my dog. Danny Tajam says, I used to have two turtles, but one of them died. When I first got them, I named the two turtles Mud and Kip because it reminded me of Mudkip from Pokemon. And I love that you took one name and just split it between the two. That's awesome. Miss DD02 says, I have a dog and her name is Sierra. I named her Sierra because her fur is the color of burnt sienna, which is sort of an orangish brown color. When I was naming her, I thought the color was burnt Sierra, not sienna, so yeah. Super Bacon says, Cece is my new pit bull's name because she was white with black spots like cookies and cream milkshake. And she's very, and I mean very energetic. She will jump on you. We found her living in my grandfather's barn. She ate a whole pan of dog food and we're keeping her. Aw, that's really sweet. Winna Lee says, I have a hamster named Peanut. And that's his name because, well, oh yeah. Well, you see, that's his name because he really likes to eat peanuts. Actually, scratch that. I don't think he's ever had a peanut in his life. Well, I need to come up with something. Oh, his name is Peanut because I really like to eat peas and nuts. And I wish there was a pea that's also a nut. Yeah, beat that. Actually, now that I think about it, no one's going to believe that. Honestly, who likes peas anymore? Well, I kind of. Oh, I hate peas. I should have called him Bacon Nut. Awesome. Gaming and Baking says, I have two cats named Chip and Dale because my family used to have a cat named Disney and our new Korats, I guess, is that a type of cat? Are energetic and fast like the chipmunks from Disney. Christy Lau says, I have two dogs, a corgi named Toffee and a toy poodle named Tinkle. Toffee was inspired by the color of her fur and she's sweet. Tinkle was inspired by the bell that she used to have on her neck when she was young because she's so tiny and we have to use it to know where she is. And I was really, when I started reading this, I was like, okay, so Toffee, sweet, and brown. Tinkle, he'd all over the place as a puppy, like tinkled everywhere. So I'm glad it has to do with like the bell making the tinkling sound instead of the dog tinkling on the carpet. Matt Brown says, I have a dog named Zeke. Here's the story behind it. We got our dog and we just didn't know what to call him. So I was sitting in a chair thinking when my mom and my brother were reading a book. My brother said Zeke while trying to say Zach. I actually thought it was a good name. Finally, we got down to two different choices, Simon and Zeke. We decided we should put him down and if he goes one way, we call him Simon and if the other, we call him Zeke. I hit a treat on one side. He went toward that side and no one noticed. He was just going over there for a treat and that's why we call him Zeke. Oh, that's great. You tricked everybody. Aubrey Brown says, I have a dog that I got from Make-A-Wish and her name is Winnie. And she's a Woodle, a Wheaton Terrier Poodle mix, which is something I've actually never heard of those two mixed together, but I could see that. I named her Winnie because I absolutely love Disney and I thought her fur kind of looked like Winnie the Pooh's fur. So that's why I named her Winnie. James Roop says, I got a dog. It's right next to this sentence. And he's got this Pluto. I love the Pluto plush toy there. Now for my, I mean, most of you guys know this, especially if you're watching Ask Think, because if you watch Ask Think, you probably know a lot about me. So my dog is a golden retriever. Her name is Kopi. And the reason that we named her is because when we got her, as a little puppy, I mean, she wasn't really coffee colored. Actually, I think she was lighter as a puppy than she is now, but like lighter in color, obviously lighter in weight. She was like 7 pounds and now she's 60. But when we got her, she would like sleep and then wake up and just start running and wouldn't stop running and biting until she fell back asleep. And then she would wake up and then start running and biting and running and biting and running and biting. And like, so... So we decided that we would call her Kopi because it is the Indonesian word for coffee. We didn't want to call her coffee. It's a little bit harder to say. And it would have worked too. But the reason that we chose that, because it was a unique name. And we felt like she was, anytime she was awake as a puppy, she was like on super caffeine. So we called her Kopi. Now for next week's question, it comes to us from Artie Tigers. And this is a good one, I think. It says, which song do you think would best describe your personality? And, of course, say why. Now, before we get to the questions from me, don't forget to leave your question in the comments below so I can have something to answer next week. Remember, only one question per comment, but you can leave as many comments as you like. Also, if the comments on this episode of Ask Think are closed, go to the most recent Ask Think and ask your question there. Now, on to the questions, and of course, I talked about it in the beginning. It is Star Wars Day! Woohoo! And Star Wars is coming out this year, and you guys saw that I did a Star Wars episode of Things Live because I couldn't resist. But what am I going to do for Star Wars Day today? Well, I mean, not a lot. My wife is at work anyway, but I'm going to Petco today because I saw they have a flyer that she can get, or that your dog can get a picture with like stormtroopers and Darth Vader and stuff. I don't know about Darth Vader, but it had a picture of a stormtrooper on it. Anyway, I'm taking Kopi there to get her picture taken. Veronica Izorieta says, why is it that this series is called Ask Think, but sometimes you ask us stuff? Well, originally it was only questions for me, and I used to have you guys guess the comment number or the number of comments or likes that would be on the video. But when YouTube switched over to Google Plus for comments, all those comments just disappeared as spam. They just boop, gone. And so I decided the next best thing would be that I would ask you guys a question as well, because, you know, it was sort of one-sided anyway, and I really, really like hearing from you guys. But MCPE asks, Think, how old are you? I've been watching for a couple months and have become a big fan of yours, and I've been wondering. You know, this hasn't been asked in a while, but if you go to my website, it's in the description on every video, and I think also on my channel page, it's thinknoodles.me. And you know what? I'm going to make you do some math, because I don't want to just tell you. I want you to do the math, and it's coming up. So you guys, some of you guys might get it wrong because it is coming up, but I was born on May 30th, 1977. So do the math, figure it out. Think Kobe Gaming says, hey, Think, is it true someone in your building just asked if you were Think Noodles? Yep, it is. I posted on Twitter just after it happened, and it actually kind of happened, and this is the first time anyone's ever, I mean, obviously I've met people, but like they're my wife's coworkers, children, or, you know, people who knew that, you know, about me because, you know, they watch YouTube videos, and, you know, then my wife's coworker says, oh, what do your husband do? Oh, he does YouTube videos. What does he play? Minecraft? Oh, my kids love to watch that. What's his name? And then they would watch, and then they'd become fans and noodlers, and then they'd want to meet me, and then they knew, right? But this is the first time someone I didn't know at all had just asked me straight out. And it happened sort of the way I expected, sort of, almost. Because, see, the way that I figure that I'm going to meet some of you guys in New York is you're going to see Kopi, and you're going to walk up, you're going to pet the dog, you're going to ask its name, it's going to be named Kopi, and come on, you know, how many golden retrievers named Kopi are there? So, obviously, you would put two and two together there. And that's kind of what this person did. You know, I was on the elevator with Kopi and taking her down, and we went out to the sidewalk, and it was a guy and a girl walking on the street. Well, they came out of the elevator with us, and we were walking, or they started to walk away, and the girl turned around, and she's like, "I have to ask you something." I was like, "Okay," and I was like, "She's gonna ask about something about the dog or something," and she goes, "Are you Think Noodles?" And I was like, yeah, but how did you? And then like while I was thinking of like how could she figure this out, I was like, oh, Kopi. Or I was like, no, I didn't say Kopi. I said, oh, the dog, right? And she's like, yeah, I figured that's Kopi. So, you know, it must be you, right? And I was like, yeah, you got it. So, you know, I said it was nice to meet her and everything, and I think they were headed out for the night. So didn't get to hang out a lot, but I'm actually. It was dark, so I mean, not that it really gets dark here in New York, but I was trying to figure out her age when I left. I was like, wow, I felt like she was older than a lot of you guys. But she said, oh, I just started watching your videos, and she'd obviously seen Kopi, so. Yep, Micah Lowther asks, or Lowther, do you do any martial arts? I do Taekwondo, and it can be extremely hard noodle on. You know, I did Taekwondo way back. Probably around the age you are, I'm not making any assumptions, but I, you know, third, fourth grade, I did it for about a year to 2 years, and, well, probably just a year, I don't know, I just really wasn't that much into it, but my parents took me to it, because, like, I got beat up, and they wanted me to be able to, like, maybe, like, I don't know, take a defense, not, like, attack people, but you know, defensively defend myself, you know, block someone trying to punch me again, I got to yellow belt with a couple of the, what are they called, notches or whatever, but I didn't get past that. Abigail Mullen says, what do you think interacts with your fans more, Think Slab or Ask Think? Oh, definitely Ask Think. I mean, Think Slab, I get to see a lot of your comments. I get to put some of your suggestions on the videos and your minion names, obviously, but the interaction isn't there. I don't, you know, I'm not actually answering questions directly from you guys. Sadie Chase says, I don't know about laws in other countries, but don't kids deserve a trial with a jury of their peers? And doesn't taking away my computer count is like abnormally cruel punishment? I asked my parents this and they just gave me a look. Oh boy, I think Sadie lost her computer privilege. Good try trying to negotiate out of that though. Winnalee says, when you went to elementary school, which we all know was somewhere in the middle of the Jurassic period, did your classroom have a single computer that everyone couldn't wait to have their turn to play Oregon Trail on? Did you learn about history while playing it? Because that's totally what it was all about. Well, it depends. In elementary school, probably, so before I moved to Indonesia, so I guess that would be pretty much through fifth grade, I actually can't remember any computers in our classroom. I could be wrong, but you know, we were living in Louisiana, and I don't know how well funded the school districts were at the time. I don't know how well funded they are now, you know, computers back then were really expensive, and there wasn't much application for them in the classroom at the time. So I really don't think that we had computers in our classrooms. When we went to Indonesia, you know, the school was better funded. And yes, we had that situation where, you know, we had the classroom had a single computer. And yes, I really, really, I mean, that was, yeah, Oregon Trail was the game for a while. And no, I didn't learn anything about history while trying to play it. I was just trying to avoid dying from diarrhea. Delina Maldonado says, think when you were younger, did you ever talk about a teacher behind his or her back? And yes, that's what kids do. Of course, we complain about our teachers behind their back and make fun of them. But I think the teachers know that. They do expect it. Perfect Kitties says, what's the best place you've ever been on holiday? That's really tough because we've been a lot of different places and each one is, you know, really good for its own reason. But I will say there is one place that my wife and I always go back to, and that is Grand Cayman and the Cayman Islands. We love it there. I could live there. I don't know what it is. It just, and the both of us have just, we fell in love with that place. And we go back every single year and we never get tired of it. And it's always just perfect. We just love it. The Man of G says, do you think it's wrong for little kids to have phones and smartwatches? I might be getting one, but I'm really obsessed with tech. No, I think it's actually wrong for little kids to not get technology and be like tech averse and not use smartphones, tablets, and computers. Because then who's going to watch my videos? No, I'm kidding. No, I mean, the reason that I really think that it's a disservice for little kids to not interact with these devices, because as they get older, when they get to the age where they're going to be in the workforce, in the industry, these things are going to be essential to their jobs. You're not going to be able to be like, oh, I don't really, you know, avoid the technology. It just won't work. So if, as a kid, you're not using these devices, you're not embracing the technology, when you get older, you're gonna be left so far behind by the other people who have used it their whole lives. Nova Cat asks, is there a lot of pollution in New York City where I live? I see blue skies every day. Lies! You're telling me that it doesn't rain a single day? Come on, not every day, but yeah, no, we see blue skies. I'm looking out right now. There's not a cloud in the sky. I see blue skies. I mean, there's pollution, of course, but I don't think it's as bad as I see in Asia, because, you know, right now I'm looking out and I see a blue sky. Yep. But I see like a layer of haze. You know, it's like a brownish yellow color. It's not like thick or anything like fog, but you can kind of see a haze. To a certain level, and then you look up higher and it's just bright blue. So yeah, I mean, there is pollution, of course, big city, but it's not so bad, and we don't see blue skies every day. We do actually have cloudy days and rain and snow and stuff, and I think you do too. Saya4Full asks, what's your favorite fruit? Mine is mangosteen. And you know, I don't really know what my favorite fruit is, but I just had to make a comment on this one because I know that I think you must be from Asia. Well, I don't know. I guess that's an assumption, but most people don't know what mangosteen is, but I never had until I went to Thailand. And I love mangosteen. And I know that it's, I think, right dead in the middle of mangosteen season right here. When we were just in Thailand, the mangosteen season was just barely starting. We couldn't really find it many places at all. I had a few of them, but that is such a good fruit. And for those of you guys who don't know, mangoes, you probably know what mangoes are. And mangosteen is nothing like a mango. It's not like another version of a mango or anything like that. It's a completely separate fruit. And, you know, if you try one, just make sure that you're near a sink so you can wash your hands, because the skin will dye your fingers red. Bunnies are cute. Ask, think, would you ever kiss a dog? I kiss my dog every day. Kobe is a very affectionate young lady. And if she gets anywhere near someone's face, she will lick your lips. TE Studios Ed says, what equipment would you recommend for a starting YouTuber, mic recording software, etc.? Honestly, whatever you have, whatever you can afford, I wouldn't recommend for a starting YouTuber to spend a lot of money. Because, I mean, you're going to want to pay a little bit for recording software, because the recording softwares that are free, I think, don't capture at a decent frame rate. So you're going to want something like Fraps or DxTory. And they're not really, really expensive. But I think that if you're going to put money into anything, it should be a recording software and, you know, a decent microphone. Really, honestly, if you got recording software and microphone, so like you could probably get away with both for less than $100 if you're on a PC. And a Mac too, actually. Honestly, you can. So yeah, that, I wouldn't recommend going and buying like a $500 microphone and, you know, $500 editing software and all of that stuff at the start. Really, really just, you know, get the stuff that is not terribly expensive, but decent quality, and then see if you really like it. And then if you really like it and you start having a following, then you start upgrading the quality. MT Loves Minecraft asks, did you get the Clash of Clans update? And if so, do you like it? Can you avoid it? I'm not sure that you can, especially because they introduced the air sweeper. So there's a new defense structure in the basis. So if you didn't get the update, I wouldn't think you could play multiplayer because you would be missing that thing. I don't know. But so far, I do like it. I mean, the air sweeper is pretty cool. And I noticed, or I read, that they rebalanced the multiplayer matching. And I've been finding a lot more bases at my level, Town Hall 8, with I don't know. I feel like I've been getting better raids for loot, farming raids. More loot, more empty collectors and stuff than normal. So far, and I've been attacked less too. So yeah, so far it's really good. I don't know if it's gonna stay that way or it's just because the update just came or something like that. But yeah, and also we were matched with a clan that, well, for once, a clan that we crushed in the clan war as well. Mine Lover says, thanks for doing the pick your chopstick, because I always forget to like your videos and I really, really like them. Well, good. I'm glad that helps, and it kind of makes you guys smile when I say, well, pick up those chopsticks and poke that like button as hard as you can. Because, yeah, I've noticed lately that the likes are starting to taper off a little bit. I've talked about this before, that if I change what I say, a lot of times it will re-prompt you guys and remind you to click the like button and help me out. Swordmaster164 says, think when you use a suggested plot in ThinksLab, why do you always change some stuff from the suggested plot to the episode? Well, so here's the thing. I take inspiration from your comments. I don't think that there's ever, because a lot of times the comments will be like, oh, do this, 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 and this. And some of those things aren't possible in Minecraft, or, you know, the suggestion is really, really minimal. So it's like, oh, there's, you know, you guys should go to a clothing shop and try on some clothes. That would be a great suggestion, right? But there's got to be more, right? There's got to be more involved in the episode than just us going to try on clothes. Something has to happen, or, you know, we have to use those to fight something or something like that. So I don't really necessarily change things, although sometimes I do. A lot of times I just add to it and make it a more compelling plot. But yeah, I love taking inspiration from your comments, because you guys think of things that I never could. Jordan Firestar says, think if you use the regular Minecraft texture pack while playing Sneaky Assassins, you can see the player better because sometimes the players move their heads up and down and you can't see what the minions. And I actually tried this out the other day. And you're right. You can see them looking up and down, which makes me think that I should be careful with looking up and down when I'm playing. But honestly, it is so much more fun playing with Kevins everywhere than it is playing with villagers. So I'll take the hit. Toad Games says, think what mod do you use in Thinx Lab that makes your hair stick out or kind of like make stick to your head? And I know exactly what you mean. It makes it look like my hair is like cubes instead of like hollow. And that is the More Player Models 2 mod. And you can find that on Minecraft forums. Megan Gibson asks, did you use the Mythbusters Star Wars special for the Thinx Lab? Because the short Stormtrooper pun was from that. Also, did you know the day was on Big Bang Theory? No, I actually haven't watched the. I didn't know that they had a new one. Why didn't my TiVo record that? I have it set to record all the new Mythbusters. I better check that. But no, I didn't know that they had done one, and I don't think I've seen that it recorded one. But no, that's actually a line. I think it's one of Princess Leia's most famous lines from, I guess, the original Star Wars, right? Or is it Empire Strikes Back? No, it's the original, right? Yeah, it's the original. Yeah. What happens in that scene is that, Luke Skywalker comes, well, Luke Skywalker and Han Solo come to rescue Princess Leia. And when Luke comes into her holding cell, he's a stormtrooper and she's in a bad mood because she's in a holding cell. And she asks him, because, Mark Hamill's not that tall. She asks him, aren't you a little short to be a stormtrooper? Because all the stormtroopers are about the same height. And he takes off the helmet and it's Luke Skywalker. So I use that from the movie. All right. Speaking of that, this is really Star Wars themed. So may the Fourth be with you all. Lucas Balestracci says, do the outro in a Yoda voice and say this. So before I do it, I will say it like that. But before I do that, don't forget to leave your comment in the questions in the comments below so I can have something to answer next week. Also, don't forget to pick up those chopsticks and poke that like button as hard as you can. Oh boy, here we go.
End of Asking 152 it is. Forget, do not to like with chopstick poke. Always as may the fourth of the doodling on be with you.
Oh gosh, that hurts my throat. All right, guys, new line.